Hi, everybody. This is Veronica. Welcome. Thank you for tuning in. I am your intuitive success coach and goddess of divine prosperity. Today, I'm doing things a little bit different. So I've really been getting the unction to do oracle card readings again. I don't know if it's because of this time of year, for whatever reason. I'm starting to notice a pattern that during this time of year, I just get led to do oracle card readings for everyone. So within the next couple of months here, for the next couple of months during the festive season, I will be doing angel oracle card readings, soul reconnection readings or soul coaching readings, money coaching readings, or money soul reconnection readings. So soul reconnection readings. So there's nothing scripted here, folks. So I'm also going to be doing channeled messages again. So I haven't been doing that in a while because of my coaching business, but I'm going to start doing that again. It feels really good. Feels really right for this time of year. So let's get started with this first oracle reading. And I'm going to go ahead and do an... where are my cards? They're not in the box. Here they are. So I'm going to give you a money soul reconnection reading for today. It's Monday. It's a good day. Let's see what the angels have to tell us for this week, okay? For our money soul reconnection reading. Okay, so, and I am using the Healing with the Angels Oracle deck by Doreen Virtue. This is my absolute number one go-to. And I also have, and also the Archangel deck by Doreen Virtue. I love, love, love. Okay, so, shuffle it a little bit more. I ask for the healing guidance and protection of the archangels and all the angelic realm, ascended master Jesus, teachers of the light. And may I hear your messages only. And so it is. Okay. One more time. I have this way of how I shuffle my oracle cards, and Spirit already knows that I don't, you know, I shuffle my oracle cards a certain way, so they work with that. Okay, so money soul reconnection reading for this week is Thanksgiving week. Oh, yay! Emerging, aww. This is a nice card. Emerging, so okay, so it looks like a lot of new things are coming up for people. A lot of thinking about career changes, thinking about money issues, money situations, your relationship with money, and something new is coming forth. You are birthing something new with, in terms of your relationship with money, okay? You may be... they're showing me that there are a lot of questions surrounding money, surrounding your relationship with money, how to manifest, how to get more, what you should ask for, because I know that's a common question when people are trying to manifest money. They're like, well, how much should I ask for? You know, what's the perfect amount? What's the right amount? Okay, so, and I have some instruction for you on that, and I'll just go ahead and let you know right now. Just go within and choose a number that feels right for you, okay? A number that feels good to you, like, but it has to be something that's reachable for you. So choose that number and then stretch it out a little bit, okay? Go beyond, okay? Don't hesitate to think large, okay? So say you want to try and manifest $5,000 within a month. And you know you can do it because you've done it before, maybe not on a regular basis, but you've done it before. So, you know it's doable, but stretch yourself out a little bit. Let's say maybe $7,000 or $9,000 or twice as much, $10,000, okay? It has to be like believable for you. Believe that you can reach it, okay? So, because that'll make it easier. It will give you a more secure feeling. So, and just stick with that number. Don't doubt, don't change it. Stick to it, stick to it, stick to it until it comes into your current reality. Okay, so a lot of money questions and a new way of thinking in regards to money is emerging. A new way of relating to money is emerging for you. So keep those questions positive and your outlook on money positive so that the positive money energy can come to you, okay? Listening. Okay. So, angels are saying here to listen to your money. Okay, that's the first thing that just came to me, is just listen to your money. I know that's, you've probably never heard of this. I don't think I've ever heard of it until just now that the angels showed me this. Listen to your money. In other words, if you're familiar with having a relationship with money, relating to money, having positive thoughts about money, and if you've been trying to improve your money story, your relationship with money, then sit down and treat it as if you would your partner, your child, your parent, your best friend, okay? Sit down, take your money out from wherever you're stashing it, preferably cash. If you don't have cash on you, take all your credit cards out, your debit, your bank cards, your checkbook. Take them all out, set them out in front of you, and have a conversation with your money, okay? And listen to your money. I know you're thinking that, well, that's stupid. But that's okay. Trust me, do it, okay? Put it on the table or on your bed or on the coffee table or outside if you're outside and you're sitting on the grass, whatever. Put your money in front of you and ask your money, what can I do for you today? Okay, how do you want me to treat you? Money, I want you to be with me. I like you. And I want more of you in my life. What do you need from me in order for you to be in my life more every day for the rest of my life? And just sit quietly and listen. Be still and listen. Be still, quiet your thoughts. And you'll get a message from your money. Okay, you'll get a message. And follow it. Follow that message. Follow it. You want a better relationship with your money? You want to reconnect with your soul money energy? Do that. Okay, and one more. Enchantment. Okay, so your money here, the angels are saying to be, let yourself be enchanted by your money, okay? In other words, be sort of charmed by your money. Let yourself be charmed by your money. Be enchanted by your money. Let your money woo you and win your heart. And don't push it away, okay? Don't push it away. You know, I know ladies and I'm sure guys too, someone's trying to get close to you, maybe kind of try to get to know you a little better. You know what I'm talking about? And they're just going, no, thank you. Sorry, I'm just going to go this way. Thank you very much. Or however you react. Well, pretend that that person trying to pick up on you is money. And just listen and just let yourself be wooed by money and let that money whisper sweet things into your ears, okay? And believe it and take it in, absorb it like a sponge and just be enchanted by your money. And I'm telling you, you're going to be amazed at the feelings you get, the freedom that you receive, and at the money that starts to flow into your life, okay? This is directly from the angels and the money energy. And so I just want to say thank you, angels, and for the money energy for tuning in with me today and allowing me to give this message to the masses or whoever will tune in. If I can help one person, then I've done my job. Okay, lovely souls, so that is your money soul reconnection reading for the week of Thanksgiving 2014. And until next time, love and prosperity.